introduction so that the people who are here can know each other. We start from the sisters, so please give stand up and give a little introduction, your name and university.
My name is Chinab. I'm from Pakistan. I'm studying at Aju University doing a master's degree. Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum. Safa Nami Ahmed. I'm studying physics in Iwa Women's University. I'm from Bangladesh.
Assalamu alaikum. I'm from Kyrgyzstan. And my name is Ibrahim Kuzibak Bubu. You can call me Baku. And I study at Iwa Women's University, political science.
Sister Safa is the sister coordinator for the MSEC and the Sister Baku is the general secretary for the sister.
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
I'm Afika from Brunei and I'm from Sejong University.
And I'm Hazima and I'm from Brunei.
Please loudly so that all these participants can listen.
My name is Hazima and I'm from Brunei and I'm studying at Sejong University.
My name is Atika. I'm from Brunei and studying at Sejong University.
My name is Hafid Al-Fumah Khairuddin, you can call me Hafid. I am in graduate program student, and then in Pune University, my major is Islamic history. I'm from Indonesia.
Masha.
Some people are on the back. My name is Nasikun, and I'm from Indonesia. And we came here on behalf of Indonesian Muslim students.
Brother is the president of the Malaysian students, or Indonesian students. Okay, you are finished. You are tenure.
And then I'm studying in Solasan University, which is because I have a master's
degree. Not see you.
I'm Solasan, studying electrical engineering at Korean University.
I want to come here.
Definitely.
Assalamu alaikum, my name is Bigzad, I'm from Afghanistan, I'm playing my bachelor in Korea University. Nice to meet you guys.
So it's great that we have the almost mashallah from every Muslim country here and from various universities. So hope so we inshallah work together, and we need the more manpower to continue our work. So inshallah after this training workshop you will be active with us. And as you know that we are also the students here, so we are trying our best to do the give the lecture and this thing, but if there is any deficiency, so you must take it as a light, that because we are also student and we are doing best. Like the previous workshop, we arranged some scholar, and this time we also want that, but the resource problem, so we are trying to manage that gap, and inshallah, we hope that it will be the more effective. So I will discuss, it will be the just review until from morning we discuss that much. I will just give a brief review on that one. So I will discuss about the what is the ideal leaders and its attributes, and then what is the dawah and its type, and then we will discuss also that how we can make a active unit or the MSEC units both in the universities or in the Korea. What are the things we need to do or we need to start as an MSEC so that we can make our dawah network as much as effective. Next.
Down.
Point
it here.
On that side.
Actually, it's not working. When it doesn't work, it doesn't work.
Okay, just point it.
No matter where you point it.
So what is the Islamic leadership? Basically, a person or a group that will lead the humanity from the brink of destruction to the way of Allah Almighty. Because Islam is a way of peace, and we are here to bring the people of Allah from the slavery of the people to the slavery of Allah. In this way, we make their lives successful. And not only the successful in this world, but also the success in the next world. So the Islamic leadership main goal is to establish Islamic state. Ultimate goal of our every dawah network, our dawah activity, or our prayer, or some activity is that we establish an Islamic state. So, what is the difference between the Islamic and the secular leadership? In the secular leadership, when it's not concerned with the Islam, it's mostly target the self-establishment, like a person is too, he can get a good position or a good fame in society. But when it's concerned with the Islamic leadership, then its main concern is only target to get Allah happiness, Jannat ul Firdaus. And the secular leadership, it works for the respect of people. But the Islamic leadership works for the pleasure of Allah. So these are the main differences that make us separate from the other religions or the other ethnic or any group. A leader is not only for the showcase or to show that his personality. A leader is always is an ideal worker. Because if he is a good worker, then he can lead the other people and he can guide them in the best way. Because when he passed through all those stages, that what the problem and how to solve them, then he can be a good leader and he can guide the people. So to become a good leader, you must be an ideal worker for your fellow. What are the primary assets for an ideal worker? The first is the knowledge. Knowledge can give you the strength to lead the people. That's why every time Islam emphasizes us to get the knowledge. And Quran says a person who has the knowledge and who don't have the knowledge cannot be equal. Like the sister was asking that why in this world we didn't see any people, Muslims, that are the occupy some good position. Because we are not good in the knowledge. And Allah says that He gave the authority to those people who have the knowledge. So in the present world, when we see the Muslim country, when we see their research production, you can see only the research paper, how much we are producing. I think we cannot only compare with any European country. So the one thing to become a leader of this present world, we must be good in the knowledge. Then we must have a faith in Allah, that the things or the activities or any work we are doing, it will be not useless. Inshallah, Allah will reward it. We must be strong belief on that. That can give us the motivation to work for the sake of Allah and for also our success in both worlds. Then, not only saying, we must act upon on our saying. What we are saying, we must act. Quran says, why you say anything that you don't act? So that is the main thing. One of the poets of Pakistan, Iqbal, said, Amal se zindagi banti hai jannat se jahannam. Your struggle in life can make you what you get, and your deeds. And Allah says, when you do the good deeds, you can get the Jannah. If you're not doing the good deeds, then it is very hard to get the Jannah. Ye shahadat kahe ulfat mein kadam rakhna log aasan samajhte hain musalma hona. The people think to become a Muslim is a very simple thing. It is a very difficult thing. When we say we are the Muslim, we are taking it so much burden on us. In Quran, Allah Ta'ala says, if we send this Holy Quran to the mountain, it will crash with the pieces. But it is the human who take this responsibility. So when we call an Islamic leader, then we need to emphasize on these qualities. That we must have a knowledge, then we must have a faith, and then we must act upon and do the good deeds. The basic qualities for the ideal workers. First, faith and belief. We must be strong in our faith that only there is one God, there is no God. When we are strong in our belief, then we can make the debate with other religion people. Like when we are doing for the Dawah work, if we are not strong in our own belief or faith, when we listen to some complicated question from them, our own imam will be stable. So we must be first have a faith and strong belief, then knowledge and wisdom, and then courage and determination. Without courage, we cannot do anything. Because if you have a fear of anything, like suppose you are in Korea, many people will say, oh, you are working for Islam. Maybe the intelligence or the Korean people think you are the terrorist. So we don't need to take much tension of that. We have the courage because we are doing the good work. We are not doing some wrong thing. So why must we be fearful? Then, mutual consultation and unity. Quran says when you solve your problem, get any problem, solve it with the mutual consultation, with shura. So the best quality for a Muslim leader or a worker is that they do the work by the mutual consultation and by the unity. Like we are here and we are belong to the different countries, so we must have a Muslim brotherhood. We don't need to take much concern about the nationalities. We must believe on the unity. That can make us a good Dawah network. Then we have the morality and faith. Like we must be honest and trustworthy. Like when we, like in our labs, if we have some task, we must do honestly. We can impress then other religion people. Suppose we are not doing the work honestly, then we cannot impress the others. And we are here the ambassador of Islam and also the ambassador of our countries. So we must have the high moral value. Then we must have good communication skills. When you are going to, suppose you are working in Korea and for Dawah and you want to preach, then you must have the, some basic background of the Korean culture and then the Korean language, then you can do the best dawa work. If we are, suppose I am only know Urdu, I can do the tarbiyah, but I cannot do the dawa work effectively in the Korean people because they don't know the language. So the communication skill is the most important for a leadership. Then the justice and compassion. Like you must do the justice and it doesn't care that it affects you or not. And justice with the compassion is the more need that you see the things logically for justice. It's not only that you listen something and do whatever you thought. You must know the phenomena, what is the happening. Then patience. When you're doing the dawa work, you have to get the many troubles. So we must be the patience. Because suppose you are working in university, every day you are struggling to call the people to come for the dawa work, come for the sekron, nobody is coming. And you say, oh, leave this, it's very hard. You must be patient. You must continue it. Inshallah, Allah will help you. And someday you will have a very strong unit in your university or the summer. So do the work with the patience. Then we have the commitment and sacrifice. We need to, suppose, we don't say you to sacrifice your education. We are, suppose you are sleeping the 10 hours or you are watching the movies on weekend, then sacrifice your that thing for the Islam. Until you don't have the commitment or the sacrifice ability, you cannot be a good dawah worker or a good leader. If you want to lead something, you have to sacrifice. Suppose you are a leader and you invited the people here and all seats are filled, then you must vacate that seat first because you are the leader. So that needs the sacrifice. And then the lifelong goal, like lifelong struggle. Just you are here in Korea and you are doing dawah work, and when you back to your country and you involve in your own worldly business and left everything, this is not. Your main goal until that is to establish Islamic society. So wherever you are, you must keep it continue. And it is the lifelong struggle. And then gratitude and prayers. Ask Allah for the help. Because without the Allah help, we cannot do anything. If we are doing too much struggle and we are not praying and we are without Allah's mercy, we cannot do anything. Then we must have a sincere toward our activities. If we get some task, we do it sincerely. Otherwise, don't take the responsibilities. And people say, we are very busy, we don't want to take the responsibility. But you must know, you already take the responsibility. When you say, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, you already declare the responsibilities. That you are the Muslim and your life is only kulinnat salati wa nuski wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alameen. My everything is for Islam. Then how you can say I am not taking the responsibility of work, I am very busy. You already take the responsibilities. No, Allah will ask you from that. So you must be sincere for that one. Then organized. Don't do the activities that you do. Organize it. It will be the more effective. And you are, even if you are working in some organization or you want to establish some business, do the work in a very good manner. Then, you must be self-confident that I am starting this work, inshallah I will do it. So when you have this self-confidence, then you can do it. And hard work and do the things regularly. Suppose we organize the MSEC workshop this day, and too many people come, and then forget. It's useless. So do the follow up the things. And start little things, but do it regularly. Instead of organizing big activity, and then wasting other time, and not putting the things in the regular time, you must, it's not effective. So do the little things, like in your university. Suppose, just start the weekly Darse Quran or Ram Darse Hadith after prayer and do it regularly, then it will be the more effective. Then good conduct. When you meet with your fellow beings, when you are living in dorm, you must be good in conduct with the people. Like if you are living in dorm, then everyone know he is a very annoying person. No one come to on your invitation. So be good in conduct with the people and your behavior. Adopt good habits and must have the good writing skills, not like me, the every time spelling mistake or the name mistakes. It will kill you. How we can improve the qualities for ideal workers? By doing the patience. If you have the patience, slowly you will improve your, you don't need too much worry that I have these, I don't have these abilities, I want to learn. You need to have patience, you need to learn. Then do the work with the wisdom. Don't need to put all the things at one point. And then the qualities of Islamic leadership are ability to command with respect. When you are the leader, then respect your fellow beings, your cabinet members, so that they will help you a lot. Then trust on the sincerity of the purpose. Like what work you are doing, you must trust on it, that it is the good and noble cause. Then confidence on your abilities, and for suggestions, when you do put your some suggestion, work on it, just not present anything. It must be a suitable approach. It must have the logics. Then a leader must be accessible to everyone. He is not only very, only busy every time, and he just meet with a few people and other workers didn't see his face. It's not. He must be accessible to everyone. Even his single member want to meet him, he say, okay, my doors are open for you and I am available 24 hours. Then ready to sacrifice, we already discussed it. Then open-minded. Don't get hyper on the little things. You got when sometime problem, please neglect. Because you are the leader. You need to keep your eyes on the objective, not on the minor things. So when you are in field, you can be good leader and you neglect little mistakes. And then understanding of the responsibilities and optimism. But you must say that we are very optimistic. Not discourage your fellow beings. Always encourage them and say, tell them the good news. That by the Allah said to the Prophet that we send them to people to tell them the good news. To preach the Islam by telling them the good deeds, you will go in Jannah and this. Then you can be a good leader. Practical qualities by leaders. Ability to help understand efficiently. When there is problem, you can understand easily. You can evaluate the problems easily. If you cannot evaluate the problem easily, then you cannot solve those problems. Then you must have the ability to answer the questions what your fellow beings are asking. Because if you didn't satisfy them with your network, your work, your aim and objective, I don't think so the people will work with you. Then love with your members, respect them. Every time when you meet, give them a smile. It will increase your affection and love with each other. Because they are not getting the pay to follow you. It is only the relationship of the brotherhood that they are respecting you and following you. So make it strength. And don't take dictatorship. Make the decision with their consultation by Shura. And encourage the criticism. Because this is the thing that can build up you. If you discourage this, then the main problem will come in the future. Then you must be dynamic. Not solve the solution every time by a single approach. You must have many different approaches to solve the problem. Serious and then the perception. That you must always keep the good perception from your own. Teaching technical qualities, you must be balanced between the idealism and realism. What is the reality? What is the ideal? Just saying or making plans that are very ideals, but in reality, there is nothing. Then you are not a good leader. A good leader is that make the balance between the idealism and realism. Then by utilizing the current resources make your target achieve. Not just you think that we need to arrange resources, then we achieve this target. Try to utilize the current resources and then manage your target. And then guide the people, make the supervision, keep check on your follower beings and your fellows, and then keep control on them. Sometimes they are doing those activities which can harm your society. You must keep check on that one. You can meet them individually, or you can consult with their shura, and you can intimate your fellow that this activity can harm the society. Please be careful. These are the responsibility of the Islamic leadership. When you are a leader of any MSEC unit or the university, your most important target is to prepare your successor. That when you leave, there must be a good leader. Otherwise, when you leave, your unit will be flopped. So a good leader must prepare a person that who will take his place, his position when he leaves. Then self-development. You increase your own knowledge also, your skills and abilities. Because if you want to keep continue and you want to achieve the big target, until you do your own capacity building, it's impossible otherwise. Then, in which area you are responsible? Suppose I am taking the media responsibility, then I must keep me skillful in that. Because when I will be the ideal for other people, then they can get the motivation. Then leadership development, more people for Islamic leadership, prepare leadership, give motivation to people, make inspire them, and then establish good financial system with the battle model, like there will be the accountability. This is the most important thing, because when you establish this accountable system of battle model, activities will be continuously going on. And then community development. You must make a nice community there when you in society that you are working, and then keep unity. That is the most important. When you are the leadership of any MSEC unit or something, like in Chungcheon or some other, every 3 or 4 months we got there some problem between the nationalities. So the leader must solve that. He must keep the unity. He don't think about the nationality of his own country or something. So these are the main responsibilities for a leader for a unit. So now I will talk about the 6 signs of the leaders. First is the ability to analyze. And this analysis can be 3 different types. Personal analysis. When you meet the people, talk with them. Until you don't talk with them, you cannot analyze your personality. Nowadays, you can even check his Facebook. That what personality he has. Then, organization analysis. You can check how organization, how strong it is, and what it is doing. Then, situation analyst. You must be good situation analyst. That this situation is what type, which decision I will make it. Because to get the perfect decision, situation analysis is necessary. Like nowadays, Islamophobia is everywhere. So if we talk the more radical things of Islam, we cannot be a good dawah worker. We must take those things that are the light. We first implement those. If we just talk about the radical and jihad and this, you can't be a good soldier. So make the situation analysis. This is the very important for making the decisions, especially when you are making some appointment as your media coordinator or same thing, or there is some problem in your society, first check the situation, then make the decision. And for a good analyst, how you can check the ability that you have the good analytical abilities? One who asks the smart question. Like you are preaching or something, or you are working in some organization, and if someone is there who asks every time some smart question, it means he is a good leader. You choose him and grow him up. Then smart mints. He gave, when you make something, you give the smart mint on that one. And a quick understanding. When there is some problem, he must understand it quickly. I explain it with a joke. A man is working in the office. His wife is very strict. Whenever he planned to do some fishing or other activities, his wife called him, come back at home. One day he decided with his friend, we will go on this Saturday for fishing and off your mobile. At the evening when his wife saw that he didn't come, he called to his friend, their mobile off. Then he called to the company. And they said he left. Until 10 p.m., 12 p.m., she waited, no one come. She called, start calling to the hospitals. She called to his families. Next day, no response. She start crying. On Sunday night, at 12 p.m., he got, his husband came with a fish. And she asked, where are you? He said, I just go for fishing. And we don't want to bother anyone, so we close our mobile. She said, what happened to you if you came in house and you didn't found your wife for 3 days? He said, no problem. She said, okay. He didn't saw her on Monday, on Tuesday, Wednesday, until he able to open his eyes. Do you understand it?
Yeah.
No one laugh on it because you didn't understand this joke. Can anyone understand this?
Can you repeat it?
No, why I repeat it? Because she beat him so badly that until 3 days he didn't open his eyes. And what about the smart mates? Same this joke, someone narrated in a such gathering, no one laughed. He waited. After 5 minutes, one person stand up and he burst up laughing. The presenter seemed happy, oh, one person is the genius leader. He at least understand that joke. He asked, why you are laughing? You understand the joke? He said, no. I am laughing because you narrate a joke and no one laughed. So this was a smart myth. So, analytical ability is that the people who have thought the smart question and understand the things quickly and make the smart commits. That is a sign of the leadership. Then a leadership must have the initiative. Who took the initiative? Who start the work, who start the project. Suppose you are in the MSEC and someone want to say, I want to start this project. So people who take the initiative, they have the leadership abilities. Then who start some projects and who lead the groups. Like you see in the friends, many people do have the friends, but only one friend always is the leader. He arrange the activities and he do the things. Then who present the new ideas, who always come with a new, like we can make the MSEC very strong if we do this, we do this. So take care of that person. He is the good future leader for your MSEC. And then who start the small organizations, like when you are in the university, he can make some debating club, he can make some other club. So person who is making the smart organization, little organization, must think that he has the good leadership ability. Suppose in the future when you have the kids, you can keep these things in your mind. You can encourage them. And one who has the creativity, these are the second sign of the leadership. Then courage. This is the most important and it is reported by all scientists who are working on the leadership. Courage is the main sign of the leadership. In a situation of fear, suppose there is an accident of the car. When people got accident, everyone is crying. Two or three people got a strong nerve. They get up and helping the people to see what need to do. So there must be no fears. Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu was very tall in his height. Even when he sit on the horse, his foot touched the earth. One day he was walking with his companion, those companion very big. And suddenly he turned back and the companion was shivering. He said, "Oh, why? Why you are so fearful? Is I do any injustice with you?" They said, "No." Then he said, "May Allah increase my fear upon you. Because if I am not doing injustice and you are fearful, it is a good thing." But same Umar, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, walking in a street, some children are playing. And when they saw the Khalifa is coming, they run away. Only one child is sitting there. Abdullah ibn Zubair. And when Umar radiallahu anhu came to him, "Why you didn't run away with your friends?" He said, "The street is not so much narrow that I run away and make way for you. There is way, you pass from it. And second, I am not doing any wrong thing. So why I have the fear?" So then Hazrat Umar radiallahu anhu said that he is the son of the Zubair radiallahu anhu, who is the very courageous and conqueror. So you must not have the fears. You must spoke out. When you're seeing any problem, speak. Don't be a dead community member. You must have courage to speak and to point out the problems. When you let out the problems go away, they will get complicated. Stop the things and ask the question. Then, criticism. The people who criticize, they are the good leader. But problem is that when criticize someone to us, we get help. The problem is that maybe we need to do him tarbiyah, that how to do the criticism. Not in the implied way, but in the polite way. But what we do? When who is a criticism, we say, "He is against us. Let's throw him away." So that is the wrong thing. The person who is doing criticism on you, it means he is the good leader of your community. Please take care of him. Then a person who has the influence on other. Like suppose you have the group of friends, but only one friend has the influence on you. So you can, when you are working in this University of MSEC, check those people who have the influence, who have the good student friends community. So make him contact and make him agree to work with you. Because when he comes in the MSEC unit, he can make it the more influential. So a leader is those who have the influence on his friends. Then he must be serious, not in the opposite of the funny. Serious means he must be serious with his life, with his target, with his objective. And he must be like, how we can check the seriousness? A person who is participating in the activism. Any activist, like any protest or anything is going on, he is continuously participating in it. Any activity is going on, he is participating in that. You can check that this person is the activist and he has the leadership abilities. So target him. Then a person who joins the clubs and organizations, he has the leadership abilities. Like he is going for the language exchange cafe, he is going for the Korean culture volunteer program, he is going for others. So it means journalism club, he has the leadership abilities. Then who has the hobbies? A leadership, a person who will be a future leader, he has the good hobbies. And then read a lot, read novels, books, newspapers. A leader is that who has the good in reading and those things. Then time management. A person who is always busy is better than one who is doing nothing. A leader is always remain busy in doing some constructive things. Then ambitious. A leader is that who has the ambitious. Like he looked to be a high person in future. Like he wanted to be a prime minister of his country or some other organization. He had big dreams. He had the leadership abilities. And wanted to leave a legacy. Suppose many of our doing research, anyone would say, I want to be a Nobel Prize winner. And he is seen ambitious, so he can be a leader. Then the sixth sign of the leadership, who can be leader? It is not basically sign, it is concerned with the environment. Families who have already have leaders, their children most probably become the leaders. Then rich families, their children can be leaders because when they are rich, they have a higher education, they have the opportunity to visit more countries and to see worlds. Because when he see the and interact with the Hmong peoples, he can get many skills and he can be a good leader. Then criticism, and then the family of activists, like persons who belong to a family who remain the activists, their children be a leader. Then orphan, who is raised by a single mom, whose father is died, he can be a good leader because he took the responsibilities from his childhood. So sometime when you in the future inshallah have your kids, try to give them the responsibilities from day one. Like I was coming and one of my friends has a kid with him at airport and he has the same one or six passport. And his kids are like 10 to 12 year olds. So for the immigration he is going, he's saying family, please keep here and I am going to. I say, why you are not giving to these kids? He say it is important. Oh, no way, just a single step. Let them do by themselves. So give the responsibilities to the people. It will make them the good leaders. Trust on them. Now we come to the Dawah, the second point. Dawah in Islam is mean the preaching the Islam, converting others' pupils religion toward Islam. And basically Dawah is the different rules and fundamentals that support and conveying and teaching the Islam to the people. It is a set of activities and things that can help you to preach. And it is the art to convince people toward Islam, toward the morality of Islam. And the Dawah also means trying to pursue the people to follow a sect, theme or a religion. Like we want that all people must follow Islam. So this is the Dawah. Are we obliged to do Dawah? We are talking about the responsibilities? Yes, this is our main responsibility. Allah said in Quran, we made you the best ummah because you work for the Dawah. You stop people from their bad things and order them for the good things. Then Allah says, "Ta'awun wa al-birri wa taqwa wa la ta'awun wa al-ismi wa al-udwan." Help the people for the good deeds and not help for the bad. Similarly, pray, sloth, and establish the Islamic system. Dawah is of two types. Some people start toward evil and some toward good. From Quran, Surah Yusuf, like the dead woman, Zulaikha, inviting the other Yusuf to Islam toward her for the bad purpose. And the prophets are there to call the people toward Islam. Style of Dawah. We can do the Dawah in the four different ways. Emotional methods. Make some speeches or make some raise some question that emotionally touch the spiritual of the person who are you to whom you are addressing. Then mental methods. You must make him to reach on that point that he start differentiated between bad and good. He can think that what is good for him in this life and what is bad for him. And then the sensory method, like it comes by the experience. like you can sense that this person has some problem and he are trying to find some spiritual solution. Or he is like scattered and want to looking for some thing which can make give him the objective of life. And like the sometime helping and giving the charity can change. Like in the Japan, until last 4 or 5 years, Japan was very strict toward the preaching of Tao activities. They don't allow the, especially the Japanese people, to convert into Islam. But when there was a tsunami and the nuclear reactor burst up, all world NGOs not went there. They were fear of the radiation. But the only Muslim community who first reached there and helped the people. They got so much impressed. Now, since 2 years, they gave the free hand to the Islam. And even the next coming World Cup, they make it title of the Islamic Friendship. So doing the charity work sometime and helping the people can attract. This affect their sense, their emotion. Then general methods, like you make question answer with them and use your presentation skills and books, literature, etc. What is the objective of dawa? When we do the dawa, we must be have the clear cut objective. That our object